Today in this video we are going to make a perfect rasgulla recipe. As you can see, it is porous, it is soft, it is spongy and juicy as well. If you watch this video in full, you will be able to avoid all these mishaps. By mishaps, what I mean, a flat rasgulla, a cracked rasgulla, a dense rasgulla, a chewy rasgulla. What's the best part? We are going to make the rasgulla without using milk. Let's begin the recipe. Hey foodies, welcome to Cooking Shooking. In this video, we are going to make a recipe of rasgulla. As you have already seen, this is going to be the perfect rasgulla recipe without using regular milk. We are going to use milk powder for this recipe. It's perfect. Why can I say that? It's because I have tried it well over 40 times, and that was 4 years ago. Right now as well, I have tried it like 6 to 7 times, and now I have come to a conclusion that this recipe will yield the best result for you. So let's get cooking. Let's begin the recipe, guys. First, we are going to take a look at the milk powder. The one that I'm using right now is from Patanjali. Reason why, this is cow's whole milk powder. It is very difficult to find this kind of stuff in India. Usually what we see in the market is skimmed milk powder or toned milk powder or dairy whitener. Those ingredients cannot be used in a recipe like this. So for perfect rasgullas, we are going to use this ingredient. So we are going to take 200 grams of this, add it to a kadhai. I am using the 500 gram packet. That is the reason I am cutting it and then measuring it. Next, we are going to add 1 liter of water. So the ratio is 5x, 200 grams milk powder, 1 liter water. We are going to mix it really well with a whisk or a spoon until there are no lumps. We are basically making the milk using the milk powder right now by saturating it, and this recipe will make you about 12 rasgullas of regular size, 14 to 18 rasgullas of a slightly smaller size. That's what I'm doing right now. And if you see carefully, the milk powders available in India are on a whiter side, whereas this one is on the yellower shade. You know it why? It's made from the cow's milk. So the milk is ready, made from milk powder. If you see any lumps, what you can do is you can take a small tea strainer and then add the milk through that so that the lumps break. Now the milk is ready, we are going to curdle it. But before curdling it, we have to heat and boil it. So here I'm placing it on top of the stove, and then we are going to heat it up in medium high flame. Stirring continuously, we are going to bring it to a boil. Be careful guys, try to use a thick bottomed kadhai, otherwise what will happen is the milk will stick and burn. If you recall, the milk powder that we used is full fat and the water ratio that we used is higher than what Patanjali recommends. So be careful, stir frequently and bring it to a boil. While that is happening, we are going to prepare an acid solution to curdle the milk. Halwais usually use the whey water that they made last day. We usually don't have that. If you make paneer or chhena regularly, you must have it. You can use that. If you don't have it, you can use some sour yogurt to curdle the milk. Along with that, you can also use some vinegar, some lemon juice, or even some citric acid. Any of these things will work perfectly. My choice is the vinegar because I have made rasgullas using milk powder, this one, quite a few times, and every time vinegar gave me the perfect result. The ratio that I follow is 1 tablespoon of vinegar per 100 gram of milk powder. So we are using 200 grams of milk powder. Here is 2 tablespoons of vinegar. Along with that, I'm going to add 4 to 5 tablespoons of room temperature water and then mix it really well. The thing is guys, you have to be as gentle and as patient as possible with rasgulla recipe, because the milk literally gets a shock when you add that acid to the hot boiling milk. That is the reason, dilute it really well, it shouldn't be very harsh, otherwise your chhena will get hard and chewy. Keep an eye on the milk, as I said earlier, stir it frequently. Also, alongside, what we are going to do is prepare some ice cold water. Just take 1 liter of water and add a few ice cubes to it, and your ice cube water will be ready. Now we are going to bring it to a boil. As you can see, the milk has started to get a boil. I'm going to turn off the flame now and we are going to lower the temperature of the milk. We don't want the milk to be super hot. If the milk is super hot, it's going to get a shock. So just try to cool off the milk, try to get rid of that super hot temperature. Just ladle it like this, or you can also add about half a cup of cold water to it, and then you will attain that hot temperature. It's been like 2 or 3 minutes and now it's the perfect time to add the acid solution, basically vinegar solution. We are going to be slow again right now. If you add too much at a time, then your chhena and your rasgulla is going to be tough and chewy. 1 teaspoon at first, we are going to mix it really well and then we are going to add few teaspoons at a time and then curdle it. I am speeding this footage right now. You can see how much I added and how frequently I added it. Patience is the only ingredient that you need for this recipe. That includes sourcing this packet of milk powder. It was really difficult for me. I hope it's not difficult for you guys. And you can see right now, our chhena is done and ready. The curdles are separate and the whey is separate. It looks great. One more thing to see is that the 2 tablespoons of vinegar solution is still left. So be slow, add little at a time. Otherwise, you are going to ruin the recipe. So be careful. This looks ready. Now we are going to immediately cool this off because it is super hot right now. Halwa is usually curdled slowly. That is the reason they don't have to be super quick and fast. They use that way as I said earlier. So we are going to add like 2 cups of cold water to it right now, which is about 500 ml or so, to cool it off immediately. Next, what we are going to do is set up a strainer and a bowl. So here I have a bowl. On top of this, I am placing a colander. On top of this, I am taking a muslin cloth. Halwais usually have 2 or 3 people waiting for them with the muslin cloth. On top of this, we are going to add the chhena and the water. The colander is too small for the chhena I made, so I am adding half right now. I am going to squeeze out the water. And then I am going to add the remaining chhena. So there you go guys, our chhena is done and ready, but it is super hot right now and it has a slightly acidic taste. So what we are going to do is take a different bowl, and you can keep this water if you are going to make rasgulla once again in a day or two. This is also very nutritious, so please don't throw it away. So we are going to get back to the chhena. As you can see right now, I am adding lots of more water, again cold water, to get rid of the acidic taste. Now, the next step is the most crucial step in the recipe. You have to get rid of as much water as possible. So be gentle, try to squeeze the cloth and not the chhena. If you squeeze the chhena, then there are high chances that the chhena might come out from the kapda or the cloth. So don't apply too much pressure, be gentle, squeeze the kapda or the cloth gently and then you will have most of the way out from this. The best way to get rid of the excess moisture from chhena is to hang it. So you can hang it in your kitchen tap or even your wardrobe or even your kitchen counter. I'm hanging it in my kitchen tap. I have lots of time, so I'm keeping it aside for about 5 hours, but please don't keep it for longer than 6 hours. Otherwise, what will happen is the chhena will get super dry. We don't want that. Be careful, if there is too much moisture, then your rasgullas will get flat. If there is too less moisture, then your rasgullas will crack. I said it in a line, be careful. I'm keeping it like this for about 5 hours. If you keep it for any longer, then the chhena will dry out too much and then it will form a skin. After about 5 hours or so, I'm heating up a pressure cooker. You can use any large vessel like this. Just that it needs to have a lot of height, like a pressure cooker. Reason why, this is cylindrical and it will boil from the sides inwards, which will result in slightly rounder rasgullas, which are more pleasing to the eye. So we are going to make the sugar syrup for the rasgulla. Here I am taking about 400 grams of sugar. The dilution of the sugar is really important. If the syrup is too thick, then your rasgullas will be uncooked from inside. If it is too thin, then your rasgullas won't hold their shape. Basically, they can get flat or even they can crack. So my ratio is 4 times, basically 2 cups of sugar will take 8 cups of water. We are going to heat this in high flame and let it boil until it gets a rapid boil. So while that is happening, we are going to get back to our chhena. So before removing the chhena from the tap, I am going to twist the cloth so that we can get rid of any excess moisture. This is dry and looks good. Now I'm going to take it out and then we are going to knead it. So here I have a tray. In this, I'm going to add it in. But if your kitchen has a marble top, please do use that. You can see the texture of the chhena. It is dry and crumbly, but somehow it binds really well when I hold it. That's how it needs to be. If there is too much moisture, as I said, things can go wrong. It needs to be like this. Now we are going to begin kneading with our palm. You can see how I am doing right now. The key step right now is to bring it together and to break down the particle size. If the particle size is too large, then your rasgullas will crack while boiling. See guys, making rasgulla is super easy if you add ingredients like maida, corn flour, milk powder, baking soda, rang kaat in numerous steps, but that's not what we are doing today. We are making it in the purest form. And if you can remember, some shops have a unique flavor to it. Mostly it's the rang kaat that they add with great additions of those milk powder and maida and corn flour while kneading it. So the art is in making it with just milk, and that's what we are doing right now. You can see the step, I'm speeding it. Some people will say you have to knead it for 15 minutes. You don't have to do that. You have to look at the texture and the quality of the chhena. This chhena will only take about 3 to 4 minutes, and then your chhena will be ready to make rasgulla. One more thing guys, if the chhena is sticking to your plate or your marble surface, then just try to gather it and then try to bang it there. It will stick again and then you won't have any more problem. The chhena is ready, the texture looks great. Now what we are going to do is we are going to divide it into smaller pieces. Usually the rasgullas that you buy from the market are of about 22 to 30 grams, but the ones that I'm making right now are of 16 to 17 grams. Reason why, many people think I'm spoofing the video. I don't want you to think that, so I'm making a slightly smaller version so that you can believe that this is made real time. Let's get back to the recipe guys. I have divided the chhena into 16 portions. Now we are going to flatten and smoothen it. So what we are going to do is take one portion, place it in our palm. With the other hand, we are going to slap it. And then what we are going to do is roll our hand on top of the chhena ball so that it starts getting round and smooth. Slowly and steadily, try to release the pressure of your other hand, and then you will have a perfect round, crack-free rasgulla ball, something like this. This looks good. Now I'm going to just repeat with the remaining chhena balls. To make chhena super sweet and yummy, most of the halwai shops also add a piece of sugar crystal inside, or even a makhana piece. That also increases the size of the rasgulla, but that's not what we are doing today. I'm just making it in the purest form. So all of the rasgulla pieces are ready to get cooked. Let's get back to the cooker with the syrup. You can see this is boiling, and also try to find a lid for this guys. That would be really helpful. The one that I'm using right now is this one. Try to ensure the steam can escape from the cooker. Otherwise what will happen is the syrup will overboil and then it will flow down your stove. The lid is also ready. I'm going to take it off and you can see the syrup is rapidly boiling. Now we are going to add the rasgulla balls, but be careful. First, we are going to add only one and we are going to see to it. We don't want it to disintegrate and break. If you are following it throughout the video right now, then that shouldn't happen with you. This looks good. What we are going to do next is add all of the rasgulla balls one by one. My rasgulla balls have been staying idle for about 10 minutes or so. So they have started to flatten out from the bottom. So a few of them I'm going to roll with my hand again and then I'm going to add them in. One more thing guys, look at my hand. It looks greasy, isn't it? That's how it needs to be, but not too much. You can see there is a limit to it. It's not super greasy. If your hand is super greasy, then your rasgullas won't be great. Reason why? They're leaving the fat. That's it. This is a very small amount of fat releasing from the rasgulla, and that's how it needs to be. All of the rasgulla balls are in right now. They are looking great. Now I'm going to cover this pressure cooker just with this regular lid for about 15 minutes in high flame. Our rasgullas will get ready in 15 minutes. Be careful guys, I stepped out after about 9 minutes and this happened. Basically the sugar syrup spilled and it got to the stove. I find it lucky for me in the sense whenever I made rasgullas and this happened, basically whenever the sugar syrup spilled, My rasgulla is way perfect. You guys be careful. I don't want your stuffed up to go bad. After about 15 minutes or so, our rasgullas will get ready as I said, and they are done right now. These are looking round and has cracks. That's how it needs to be. If your rasgulla doesn't have cracks, then how can you expect the syrup can go inside? Looks perfect. We are going to take it out, guys. So here I have a metal bowl. What I'm going to do is first I'm going to ladle out the syrup. I'm just taking about 3 or 4 ladlefuls of the syrup right now into a bowl, and then we are going to transfer a few of the rasgullas and then some more syrup, few rasgullas. The thing is, guys, these rasgullas are like babies right now. They will take the shape of however we keep them, so be careful with that. Rasgullas are done, but they are not ready to eat right now. They are not even completely sweet. So what we are going to do is make them sweeter for everyone of us to eat, just like we get in the mithai shops. So here is the remaining syrup inside the cooker. As you might have noticed, I didn't add all of the syrup to the bowl. We are going to add 200 more grams of sugar to this because it's not sweet enough. Usually the halwais make two kinds of syrup, one for cooking the rasgulla and the second one for serving and storing them. That's not what we are doing today. We are making one simple syrup for cooking them. Later on we are going to thicken it. So I'm just boiling the sugar again for one more minute so that it can melt evenly. After that we are going to transfer it to the rasgullas. Try to do this step as immediately as possible because this step is really crucial for the rasgullas to hold their shape. So I have immediately transferred the thicker syrup into the rasgullas and that is looking good right now. You can see the cracks and the shape. The thicker addition will ensure these hold their shape and also get sweeter. Perfect, they are looking nice. They also have cracks. If it doesn't have cracks, it's not perfect. That's what I believe. But these are not ready to eat right now, guys. As I said, rasgulla is a recipe of patience. You have to wait for 8 hours so that they can get sweeter and they can hold their shape. Right now, they are like cotton. If you try to press with a spoon, it will stay pressed. After about 8 hours or so, we are going to serve it. But please don't keep it inside the fridge. You can see the rasgullas, guys. Next day it's looking perfect. They have gained so much more confidence right now. The shape is looking nice. The texture is looking great. And also our chota ustad is also looking good. So now we are going to serve them. Rasgullas are just like how they need to be. Made super easy with this recipe. This is soft when you cut with a spoon and bite into it. Spongy when you feel like testing them like this or when you want to eat it without the syrup, and porous when you break into it like this. Super juicy, super tasty, soft, spongy and tasty rasgulla recipe. That's what this video was. So there you go, guys. That was my rasgulla recipe without using fresh milk, without using any chemicals, without using any flour or a starch. You can eat it at a fast. I mean, agar aap vrat kar rahe ho tabhi bhi aap kha sakte ho to banaiye. I mean, do try it and share with me how it goes for you. Just like my old video, this one again was a very difficult recipe to compile, but once it was ready, it is like repeatable in the sense, if you watch this video carefully, if you had watched this video carefully, you can easily make it at home. So try it out, share with me how it goes for you. See you soon with one more delicious recipe. If you liked the recipe, give it a like. If you disliked it, dislike kar do yaar, not a problem. Bye for now.